Hello and welcome to the episode 70 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. The highlights of the day are a big beat session, the first visit of the Beatles at the Twickenham Film Studios, and several recording sessions. On the night of the 11th of March 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed twice in their hometown, Liverpool. First, there was a concert at the Aintree Institute. Then, they had a slot during the first big beat session at the Liverpool Jazz Society. This kind of night was an innovation of promoter Sam Leach, a 12-hour session running from 8 p.m. on a Saturday night until 8 a.m. on a Sunday morning. There were 12-hour-long slots, one per band. The bill was stopped by Jerry and the Pacemakers, but also featured the Beatles, the Rhythm of Four, Rory Storm and the Hurricanes, King Size Taylor and the Dominoes, the Big Three, Derry and the Seniors, Ray and the Del Renas, Dale Roberts and the Jay Walkers, Johnny Rocco and the Jets, and Farron and the Tempest Tornadoes. The admission to the show, billed as the Rock Around the Clock All Night Rock Ball, was also relatively cheap. Members of the Jazz Society paid 6 shillings and 6 pence, about £7 in 2020 money, while non-members paid a shilling more, 7 shillings and 6 pence, about £8.50 in 2020 money. The venue could host a maximum of 1,000 people together, but Leach calculated that some 2,000 people attended at least a part of the show on this first occasion. It was a success. He would replicate this experiment in different venues in the next 2 years. In 1962, the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums, performed at the Casbah Coffee Club in Liverpool, the club in the Best's home cellar, owned by Pete's mother, Mona. Moving to 1963, the soon-to-be Fab Four spent the evening at the EMI House in London, recording their fourth and final appearance on the Friday Spectacular, which would be broadcasted on Radio Luxembourg on the 15th of March from 10 to 11 p.m. The lads chatted with the host and the recording of Please Please Me and Ask Me Why were listened to, with live audience reaction. The national package tour with Chris Montez and Tommy Rowe was having a day of rest, but the Beatles kept working on anyway. Before moving on, let me remind you to be fab yourself and visit www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to support this podcast if you like what you're hearing. I would also love to hear what you think about my work, so by all means, don't be shy and drop me a line telling me what you like and what I can improve. Thank you! On the 11th of March 1964, the Beatles had their first shooting session at the Twickenham Film Studios in Twickenham, where they would return time and again for all kinds of films and promotional shootings. Today, though, they worked on their A Hard Day's Night feature film, the session starting at 8 a.m. and ending at 10 p.m. The lads filmed the scene of them playing cards and mimed They Should Have Known Better on a set arranged to look like a train guard's van. In 1965, in the morning, the Beatles landed in London at 7:05, arriving from the Bahamas, where they had completed the first part of the shootings for their second feature film. In 1969, there was a second mixing session for Glyn Johns to mix songs from the Get Back rehearsals and recording sessions and compile a tentative master tape of the album. Today, he tackled Two of Us, The Long and Winding Road, and Lady Madonna. As usual with Johns, the session took place at the Olympic Sound Studios in London. On this same day, in the Apple's basement studio, George Harrison and Paul McCartney produced a session for Jackie Lomax's second single, featuring the Coasters' Tumbling a Ride on the A side and a song by Lomax, Going Back to Liverpool, on the B side. George and Paul performed lead guitar and drums, backing vocals and rhythm guitar on the tracks, respectively. The single ended up having a new song, New Day, on the A side and Tumbling a Ride on the flip side, though. Going Back to Liverpool was released as a bonus track on the 1991 reissue of Lomax's Is This What You Want? Finally, on this date in 1970, George Harrison was at the Aeolian Hall in London to record an interview with Johnny Moran for The Beatles Today, the Easter Monday BBC Radio 1 special about the Beatles and Apple record artists like Jackie Lomax, Billy Preston, Doris Troy and Radha Krishna Temple. During the chat, George admitted that he couldn't stand watching the forthcoming Let It Be film, although he said that it could be interesting for those who wanted to see how the band worked. Harrison also commented favorably about the rough edge of the recordings and stated that, although he was starting to plan his own solo debut album, the band would soon regroup and work together again. All in all, the interview taping took an hour, from 5 to 6 p.m. The program, including a 3-minute 13-second version of Dig It, was aired on the 30th of March, between 4:31 and 5:15 p.m. In the evening, there was another session for Ringo's It Don't Come Easy, again probably at the Trident Studios and again with George Harrison producing. And so, another episode of What A Fab Day is over. Tomorrow I'll treat you with quite a bit of commotion happened on the 12th of March 1969 and naturally with other stories from the history of the Beatles. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation. Simon Mas, music you love.